Hey everybody, today we're going to learn how to send over an xAPI statement from a SurveyMonkey without doing any type of code to Watershed, the learning record store. And so we're going to do all of that again with no code today. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts. I cover a lot of topics on xAPI. You can also check out templates. I have different templates on Articulate Storyline. I also have different templates on xAPI in video. And then also full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Score, and HTML5 video. But today we're going to focus on using a connector tool called Zapier to be able to take the data from a SurveyMonkey and track it inside of xAPI. Now, Zapier is nice because you can connect over 4,900 applications from one API to another API. Now, there are different APIs that you can do. You can do Google Sheets, you can do Trello. So different events that happen in these applications, you can track through xAPI. Now, you can also add on additional things. So not only if you wanted somebody to fill out the survey, you wanted to track to xAPI, but you also wanted to go in and send over a Trello card so you can follow up with a Trello card. So there's a huge potential to be able to automate some of your workflow and even, you know, send out emails and other things like that automatically if this event happens. So Zapier is huge, has huge potential and great power to be able to connect these different applications together. And the nice part is you don't need to know any type of code. So let's go ahead and explore it a little bit with that example of I set up a SurveyMonkey here, and I want this SurveyMonkey to be just so somebody goes in and they fill out a form to track learning that's outside of the learning management system. So if somebody takes or listens to an audiobook, or if they go to a conference or something and you want them to be able to track it to count towards a learning challenge or something like a drawing at the end of the month or something like that, you could do that with something like this. And so SurveyMonkey allows me to, I'm capturing their name here inside of the survey. Now, SurveyMonkey does allow you to authenticate, so they have to actually authenticate through like a single sign-on or something, and it will capture the person's name that way. But I'm capturing it right inside of the form here. Now, I'm also giving some categories of the different types of learning that they could do that they could select here, or they could just specify in other, and that's going to become important when we start to send over the information. And then how much time did they spend, and then upload. Now, the upload proof is actually a paid feature. So if you want this part where they have to actually upload proof, you will need to have a paid account of SurveyMonkey. So keep that in mind. All right, so I'm gonna go into Watershed. Now, Watershed is, you can sign up for an Essentials LRS, a learning record store, that allows you to send over real-time data. It does not allow you to customize the reports at all. So if you wanted custom reports on your dashboard or shareable reports with stakeholders or something like that, you will need to have a paid account. But for this test and just for like, you know, basic data that you wanted to go over, you can sign up for the free account. So I'm gonna go ahead and go into here. One thing that you need to do to set up here is you need to go into your xAPI data here, and you need to have grab your endpoint, and I set up this key and secret, this activity provider with a key and secret. Now what this is, and I'm gonna change these key and secrets after this video, so keep that in mind, but what this is it allows you to connect and send data over so you're not opened, so not anybody can just go send over data to your learning record store. And so that's the reason, and also allows you to define where the data is coming from. So do you want it to come from Zapier, or you could call this learning tracker or something like that. You can define where that's coming from. So you can see here, I have a training videos, a cooking 101 course. You don't need to do it for every course, but possibly different locations of where the data is coming from. You might want to set up an activity provider for that. So everything is set up inside of Watershed. Now, one thing you also do need to do inside of SurveyMonkey is you need to start collecting at least one response. And so if you preview and then you go into collect responses, There are different types of collectors. You can collect information through email, through web link, post on a social media website collector as well. I created a web link, but that's going to become important when we start to send over the survey to where we're grabbing this data, because you could be grabbing it and changing it based on the collector as well. So keep that in mind. All right, so I'm now going to go in and create my Zap. So a Zap is a connection between two different applications. And so when an activity happens in one application, it will trigger an activity in a different application. That's really the essence of Zapier. And you're using, behind the scenes, Zapier is using APIs from all these different applications in order to make this happen. So it's a whole lot easier to kind of create these connections and automate your workflow and everything like that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Create a Zap. Now, inside of here, this is, you can see there's a lot of powerful applications already to begin with. If you wanted something to happen when somebody creates a card inside of Trello and you wanted that to be sent over to a learning record store, you could do that, or a Google Calendar or something like that. So with the potential of xAPI and the potential of Zapier and all these different applications, you can start tracking a lot more than you're currently tracking at the moment with xAPI. So that's why I wanted to cover this video. I'm gonna go ahead and say SurveyMonkey here. Now you do have to choose the type of event that happens in SurveyMonkey. So what I wanna do is new response with answers. I don't want, if somebody just hit submit, I don't want the response without answers. I wanna make sure that they've actually answered something. So I'm gonna say new response with answers. Now we'll go ahead and continue, and it will ask me to log into my account, and you can connect several different accounts here. And all you have to do is log into your account and then authorize it, and that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna select that one here, hit continue, and then I'm gonna go into SurveyMonkey and say, we're gonna go in and grab the record or record learning experience. Now these are the different collectors, which I've only created one, which is that web link. But if you created an email link or something like that, you may connect and do different zaps based on the different collectors if you wanted to. I'm gonna say web link here and then hit continue. Now it's gonna test your trigger. Now this is important because you need to actually come in here. I'm gonna go into this and copy URL. We need to fill out this form at least once. It needs to have some type of information in order for this to work. I've already filled it out, so keep that in mind, but it needs to at least have one response. I'm gonna go into here and I'm gonna hit test trigger. It's gonna pull the information, that one response in, and I could double check to make sure all that information is coming in. You can see right here, Nancy Wright, Jeff Batt at Gmail, college class, and so forth. It doesn't really matter the data that's coming in right now. It's just showing you sample data of what's coming in. And then I'm gonna hit continue. Now this is where I then go into Learning Record Store and start to trigger the event for Learning Record Store. If you type in LRS, notice that there is also a GrassBlade LRS. So if you're using GrassBlade, you could do this type of connection as well. I'm using Watershed, and this, I'm using just the free account of Watershed. And so I'm gonna come in here and say, send a statement. Now, if you wanted to, and you know exactly what you're doing with xAPI, you could do an advanced statement, and you could probably get into some of the JSON and edit some of that, so keep that in mind. But I'm gonna send the statement, and then we're going to choose the account, which I've already connected my account. When you connect your account, this is actually where you enter in the key, the learning, the endpoint, the key and the secret, and so forth, so keep that in mind. I've already connected it, and so now it's going to basically bring all that information in, and now I could set up the statement. With xAPI, besides, you know, Storyline makes it a little bit easier now, but not as easy if you're sending to an external learning record store. But with xAPI, now you have to define some of the different elements. So the name, who the person is, the actor, the verb, what action did they do, and then also the object, okay, and then you describe what the object is. So for example, Jeff Batt filled out survey. So filled out's not really a verb, but it would be more like completed or experienced or something like that, and then the survey with additional information. So we're gonna do that. So we're first of all have to capture the actor's name. Now we're capturing the full name inside of the survey. I could type here if I wanted to, but it's also given me the ability to pull information from that survey that I've created. Now I'm gonna click on show all options. Now you may get confused because there's a first name and a last name. Now the first name is the if you're authenticating through SurveyMonkey. Now, I am not authenticating through SurveyMonkey. If I go into the design survey, or actually I'm going to go into collect responses, and I'm going to go into edit collector here. This is where you could set up authentication if you wanted to. Now, I do need to make sure that multiple responses is on. If this is a learning tracker, I want them to fill it out several times. That is already on, so keep that in mind as well. All right, so going back into Zapier, we're going to grab the name that we're actually, they have inside of the survey here, which is this Nancy Wright full name there. That is the actor. I don't need to enter in any other information. That's going to be the actor. Now we need to grab the email. Now, if I was doing the SurveyMonkey authentication, I would grab it there. So keep that in mind. If you see something as far as email address, if it doesn't have any sample data in there, that's probably not the one you want to grab. I'm just going to come in here and grab this email one. And so now I have that email there. All right, so that's looking good. Now the actor account name, this would be something like Learning Dojo, your company name, the account page. And so I'm going to go ahead and just grab my Learning Dojo here. And I don't need the index.html, learningdojo.ninja. And then this is where I can choose the verb. What type of verb am I actually going to use? So I like the verb experienced. So I can just say experience, and then it will show up as experienced here. And I could change that if I wanted to, but if I don't change it, it'll just say experienced, and it automatically gives me the activity ID. And so the activity ID is important because that's how it will recognize what type of action, and the learning record store actually looks more at the ID than it does the name itself. So, all right, so the activity name, this is the object essentially, like what is it going to say? Jeff Batt experienced, what did he experience? Well, he experienced this learning tracker, so we can say experience, or we're actually capturing what they experienced, and that is in the survey of the category that best fits your type of learning. So Jeff Batt experienced college class at the amount of time, and then we could say, let's capture the amount of time there, how much time is spent on learning, 2 hours, and we can say 2 hours if we wanted to. So you can kind of add on the data or insert the data where you want and then just add on to it as needed. Now I'm going to come into the description. Now the description shows up once you expand it out. If I go back into Watershed and then I go into the data search here, if I click on this, this is where the description, that's not a good example, but right here, down here is the description right there. So it's only there if it gets expanded out. So if I wanted to, I can add more additional learner completed the contents and so forth, whatever you wanted to add there. Now this part I failed to actually fill out because this is usually your website to be able to make this activity, this learning activity unique. It doesn't have to be a real URL. It could be like whatever the activity itself, like, or not course 101 in this case, new learning tracker. This is just basically identifying where the source of this data or what the learning activity is. It's a unique ID. All right, so other stuff is optional. So if you wanted to add on extensions or results or completion or duration, which honestly, if I come into here, duration is the amount of time that it took to fill out the survey. So keep that in mind, or you can grab the duration from here if you wanted that to be the duration of the number of hours or something like that. So again, keep that in mind there. I'm going to leave that blank for now. You can say score, other things, and then you could add more context as well. I'm going to go ahead and hit continue, and we're going to do test and review. Now it's going to send over a test to my learning record store. So if I come over here and hit refresh, you can see right here, Nancy Wright attempted college class at the amount of 2 hours. So I know the data is going through, and that's what the test does. It'll take that sample data and it will push it through. So I know everything is actually working. So let's go ahead and turn this on now. So you do have to publish this app. So publish and turn on. If you don't see the turn on or the on button, you know that it's not fully published yet. But as soon as it's published, now I know that I could send this link out to anybody and it's going to basically work. And I can see that on button here. Now I may want to give this a name. So new learning tracker test. And I'm just going to say test there. But let's go into our survey and let's say Joe Schmo. And I'm just going to use my Gmail. And we're going to finish the plural sites on the second and how much time I spend, about 5 hours on it. I'm not going to upload any proof and I'm going to hit submit. So inside of Watershed, it takes a little bit, so keep that in mind. But inside of Watershed, it will send over the data. It's basically sent it over to Zapier. Zapier is now going to trigger over the statement to Watershed, and it really just takes like under a minute. In fact, there it is right there. Joe Schmo attempted plural site at the amount of time of 5 hours. So you can take an application that you use often and trigger xAPI statements. That is huge. That has a lot of potential here. So I'm going to go into this new learning tracker, and I want to talk about one more thing. If I go ahead and hit close on this, notice if I click on edit Zap, I can do more. So I can not only send over an xAPI statement, but I can also trigger a card inside of Trello. I have a Trello board right here that you can see I triggered a statement to come over into this card, and then I can move that card over. Now I can then even trigger something inside of Trello to send out an email. If I go ahead and just move over to completed, it'll send out an email to somebody saying that they've completed it. So there is huge potential here. With the free account of Zapier, you can only do one connection. But if you do the paid account, which again is not much in my opinion, but if you do the paid account, you can do kind of branching connections as well. So a lot of potential here to automate your workflow, to send over xAPI statements with Watershed or Grassblade, and hopefully other LRSs kind of hop on board here and enable this. But that's what I just wanted to show you, is the ability to automate and to use the Zapier application to send over xAPI, or to just, you know, do other things, connect other applications in general. So if you want to check out more, especially on xAPI, go ahead and go out to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out my blog post, you can check out other templates as well, and then you can check out my full courses on Articulate, Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate. If you want to dive more into xAPI, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And also, if you like this video and want to see more, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel. If you go into any of my blog posts here, and then you just go ahead and watch on YouTube, you can like and subscribe to my YouTube channel right there, and you'll be notified of all future videos as they come out. But that's all that I have for today, so I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, everyone.